Welcome to Well Explained. I'm here once again with the chapter motion, lecture 2 of class 9th physics. Students, before starting the chapter, I want to say, please subscribe my channel. Press the bell icon so that you never miss a class from me. So here is the chapter, concluding part of the chapter. Coming to speed. Speed of a body is the distance traveled by the body in unit time. That is, the formula for speed is equal to distance upon time. Students, in your class 8, you used to write this formula as S is equal to D upon T. But actually, speed is denoted by the letter V, distance by S, and time by T. If a body travels a distance S in time T, then its speed V is equal to S upon T. The SI unit of speed is meter per second. Since speed has only magnitude, it is a scalar quantity. For example, you can see in this slide, there are two cars, a red car and a gray car, car A and B. The car A is running at a speed of 40 meters per second and car B is running at a speed of 30 meters per second. For car A, the 40 meter per second means in 1 second it is covering 40 meter, and car B also in same 1 second it is covering 30 meters. That means the speed of car A is more than the speed of car B. From this we can conclude that A is moving fast whereas B is moving slow. So this is speed. Now coming to what is average speed. Average speed is the ratio of the total distance traveled to the total time taken. Students, it is not possible to maintain a uniform speed throughout the journey. Suppose we have to move from place A to place B or from your home to your school. Okay? When you start your journey, is it possible that you maintain the same speed from your home to the school? No. Somewhere there may be speed breakers, somewhere there may be traffic, somewhere there may be empty road. The speed will be different for all the three places. In that case, average speed is calculated and it is total distance traveled to the total time taken. Suppose a car travels 85 km from point A to B, then 45 km from point B to C. The total time took was 1.3 hours. You have to tell what was the average speed of the car. First of all, we will find out the total distance traveled from A to B plus B to C, that is 85 km plus 45 km, which is equal to 130 kilometers, and the total time of the journey is given 1.3 hours. The average speed is equal to total distance traveled upon total time, that is 130 divided by 1.3, which is equal to 100 kilometers per hour. The SI unit of speed is meters per second. As the SI unit for distance is meter, SI unit for time is seconds, the SI unit of speed is meters per second, but it is a smaller unit, so we use the speeds in term of kilometers per hour. Now coming to velocity. The quantity which specifies both the direction of motion and the speed is called as velocity. Velocity of a body is the displacement of the body per unit time. The speed was distance upon time, but the velocity is displacement upon time. That means there is a difference, both are same, but there is a difference of direction. The speed is only magnitude, no direction was there, whereas in velocity there is magnitude as well as direction. Since velocity has both magnitude and direction, it is a vector quantity. Now you can see examples. The first car is moving 30 meters per hour towards east. That means magnitude as well as direction. Second, 60 meters per hour east. This is also moving with direction. And the third is also moving with direction. It is 60 meters per hour towards northwest. Speed with direction is known as velocity. It is also denoted by the letter v, small v, but with a direction it is always written. In for the sake of convenience, we take speed and velocity as same while discussing the numericals or discussing anything. But speed is without direction, velocity is with direction. Now what is average velocity? It is the ratio of the total displacement to the total time taken. Average velocity is also the mean of the initial velocity u and final velocity v. Whenever we start from any speed, so that is known as the initial velocity. If we are starting from rest, our initial velocity will be zero. That is u is equal to zero. And there is a final velocity which is v. The average velocity is equal to sum of these two velocities, that is initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2, or we can say u plus v upon 2. Speed and velocity, they both have the same units, that is meters per second. The only difference is that speed is without direction, velocity is with direction. There is one example problem. If a car changes its speed from 10 meters per second to 20 meters per second in just 5 seconds, what is the average velocity of the car? From this problem, you can see the initial speed or the initial velocity is 10 meters per second. Okay. And final velocity is 20 meters per second. And the time taken is 5 seconds. The average velocity is equal to u plus v upon 2, that is 20 meter per second plus 10 meter per second divided by 2, that is 30 meters per second divided by 2, which is equal to 15 meters per second. The average velocity of the car is 15 meters per second. Now coming to acceleration. You must have heard this word acceleration or the word like this. Yes, in your vehicles there is an accelerator. And what is the use of accelerator? To increase the speed. The quantity which specifies changes in velocity is known as acceleration, and acceleration can be defined as the rate of change of velocity. The formula for acceleration is final velocity minus initial velocity divided by 2. Not 2, it's t. Sorry, by mistake I've written it as 2. It's final velocity minus initial velocity divided by t. If the velocity of a body changes from initial velocity value u to final value v in time t, then acceleration a is equal to v minus u upon t. Students, this formula is not correct. It's v minus u upon t. The SI unit of acceleration is meter per second squared. Now distance time graph. Motion can be represented on the distance time graph. In the graph, distance is taken on the y-axis and time is taken on the x-axis. The distance time graph for uniform speed or uniform velocity is a straight line. This is because in uniform speed or velocity, a body travels equal distances in equal intervals of time. This is an example of uniform motion. You can see time is taken on the x-axis and distance is taken on the y-axis, and the graph is a straight line. Now derivation of three formula, or you can say three equations of uniformly accelerated motion. Means these three equations, v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, and v square is equal to u square plus 2as. These are the three equations of motion. And sometimes students, you have to learn it like that. This only, the first equation of motion is v is equal to u plus at, second equation of motion is s is equal to ut plus half at square, and the third equation of motion is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Because sometimes in questions it is asked to derive the second equation of motion. But if you will not be knowing ki which is the second equation of motion, so how will you derive it? You have to learn also ki what are the three equations of motion and number 1, 2, 3 also. These three equations of motion holds true for all the uniformly accelerated motion. Uniformly accelerated motion means they are acceleration, the rate of change of velocity is uniform. That is, velocity is changing at a constant rate. Now, let a body is moving with initial velocity u with uniform acceleration a. Its velocity becomes v in time t seconds. In the meantime, it covers the distance s. The term would be in acceleration, meter per second square, initial and final velocity is meter per second, time is second and distance is meter. Now, first equation of motion. We know acceleration is equal to v minus u upon t by the formula. A is equal to v minus u upon t. We'll shift t from the denominator to the left hand side. It will become at is equal to v minus u. And if we transpose u to the left hand side, it will become u plus at is equal to v, or v is equal to u plus at, which is our first equation of motion. Now, coming to the second equation of motion. Average velocity is equal to v plus u upon 2. We have learned it. Okay? U plus v or v plus u upon 2, it is one and the same thing. Now, distance traveled is equal to average velocity into time. Plus nahi hai ye beta, into hai. The s is equal to v plus u upon 2 into time. From first equation of motion, we know v is equal to u plus at. So, substituting this v by u plus at, it will become s is equal to u plus at plus u upon 2 into t. U plus u, it is 2u plus at divided by 2 into t. We'll multiply both the sides, terms of the binomial, that is 2ut plus at square upon 2, and if we'll write it as 2ut upon 2 plus at square upon 2, 2 se 2 cancel ho jayega, s is equal to ut plus half at square. So here this is not plus, it is multiply, means in distance traveled is equal to average velocity into time. Now, the third equation of motion, that is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. We know that v is equal to u plus at, that is v minus u is equal to at, and from here we'll find v minus u upon a is equal to. Now, coming to the second equation of motion, that is s is equal to ut plus half at square. We know our third equation of motion is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. There is no t. So, what we will do in this second equation of motion, we will substitute the value of t from the first equation of motion, that is t is equal to v minus u upon a. S is equal to u. In place of t, we will write v minus u upon a plus half a. T square ki jagah hum likhenge v minus u upon 2 in the bracket whole square. And we will solve it and you will get the equation v square 2as is equal to v square minus u square, or v square is equal to u square plus 2as. And this is the third equation of motion. Now, coming to circular motion. The motion of a body in a circular path is called as circular motion. What is uniform circular motion? Uniform word aate hi. If it covers when a body is moving in a circular path and it covers equal distance in equal intervals of time, then it is known as uniform circular motion. If a body moves in a circular path with uniform speed, its motion is called uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion is accelerated motion because in a circular motion, a body continuously changes its direction. So there is a difference between uniform linear motion and uniform circular motion. Linear means the body is moving on a straight path. Circular means it is moving on a circular path. Uniform word is common, means the body is covering equal distance in equal intervals of time in both the motions. But uniform linear motion, as direction is not changing, it is not accelerated. Whereas uniform circular motion is accelerated. Why? Because the body is changing its direction continuously. Now we know the velocity is given by displacement upon time. Here in the circular path, the displacement is the circumference of the circle. So formula becomes V is equal to 2 pi r upon t. Okay, by mistake it is 2. Sorry, the circumference of a circle of radius r is given by 2 pi r. If a body takes time t to go once around the circular path, then the velocity V is given by V is equal to 2 pi r upon t. And the units are the same, that is meters per second. This is the example, accelerated motion. Why? Because the direction is changing again and again. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Press the bell icon so that you never miss a